Hi, this is Sulab. So this is a simple implementation of MVP architecture in Android. This project here is I'm recording this video for myself so that I can look it up later on, maybe during interview. So what I'm trying to do is, so I won't just write everything in front of you because it's just a waste of time. So I have created a view over here, a linear layout with two edit text and one button. So these two fields are for email and password, and whenever the login button is clicked, corresponding actions are done. So right now we'll have only one activity. So in modal view presenter, I'm trying to implement modal view presenter MVP here. So modal is for data, which I'm sorry I haven't dealt with that here. View is the activity class or the layout file. Both of these fall under the view block. And modal view and presenter, we will have one presenter which will deal with, like, for example, when you click on any button, the clicking and all will be done in the activity or in the view, because the user interaction, everything will take place in the view. And whenever we have to, like, the views, the actions that we take in the view will be sent to the presenter, so that the presenter can, like, will take care of what has to be done with that action. And maybe if something has to be updated to the database, or like something has to be done to the view, that will be returned correspondingly. So we will have one contract or one interface per activity. That's what I'm trying to do. So for the main activity, I have created one interface called main contract, which will be the, like, a link between the view and the presenter. Main contract is the interface which will have two interfaces within it. One is the presenter interface, the other is the view interface. So this view interface will be implemented by the view or the activity, and the presenter interface will be implemented by one presenter class, which I'll explain later. So in the presenter class, what like method we have to include is, whenever we, like, for example, whenever we click on a button on the view, after clicking on the button, we will get the email and password from here, and then we will send that email and password to the presenter. That I'll show you later. Okay, that username and password will be sent to the presenter, and the presenter will deal with it. I mean, activity doesn't have to deal with the business logic. The activity is a view component, so it will only, what it will do is, it will take input from the user, from the view, and then send that input to the presenter, and the presenter will think about, presenter will deal with the business logic, and whatever has to be done, it will, if anything has to be done with the view, then it will send back the response through this view methods which are here. Like, for example, when the presenter receives the email and password, it will check if the email and password are correct or not. And if the email and, suppose if the email and password are correct, then it will call the sign in success method which the view has implemented. So okay, the presenter interface will have the method which usually, like, you can think it in this way. The methods which will be written here are those methods which will deal with the input that they receive from the view. And after analyzing these inputs and all, what has to be done on the view has to be passed to this method. So let's see the present. Okay, let's start from there. Okay, first of all, this is view, these two are view, and this is the presenter. So every time, remember, the view class will have an instance of the presenter, Okay, no, before that, the first thing is main activity has to implement main contract dot view. Okay, main contract dot view, because activity is a view, so it has to implement the view, and main presenter is a presenter, so it has to implement the presenter. Okay, by implementing this presenter, this main contract's presenter, this agrees that it will follow, like it will implement all the methods that has been written on the main contract. So in the view, we will get instance of the presenter, and in the presenter we will get instance of the view. Okay, so here in the presenter we will create a constructor where we initialize the view, and here in the presenter here in the view class we pass the instance of this by like main contract dot mbb presenter presenter equals to main presenter this. This can be written here because this class implements view, so we are passing the instance of view to main presenter, so that can be like instantiated here. Okay, so init view will just get like set up these names. After that, whenever the button is clicked, we will get the email and password from the field, and then check if they are empty or not. If they are empty, if any of these fields are empty, we will just call the sign in error method of this class, of the view class itself. But if they are not empty, any of them are not empty, we will pass this email and password to the presenter's handle sign in button. Okay, so what happens is this business logic need not be dealt in the activity class, because activity should not have any activity is a view class, and it should not have any business logic, it should not know any business logic. So this has to be passed to the presenter class. Presenter class is here. So here this email and password are received, and then it will check. Right now I haven't like made any API calls and all. I have just checked the email and password with this static email and password. So if the entered email and password are equals to this and this, it will like the view has to be updated, or a toast has to be shown. In this case, I don't need to make any database request if the email and password are correct. We just need to show a toast message in the view or in the activity if they are correct. So we again call, since we have the instance of the view, we again call the sign in success method of this activity. So in the, when we call that, it will just show sign in successful. So let's run this app once, and then let's see if it really runs or not. I don't know where it went. Who is the emulator? Okay, that's it.